In 2007, Dr. McKill and the International Rice Research Institute led a field experiment with a strain of rice, IR64, that contained the Sub1 gene. On day 25, the fields flooded for around 17 days. As the water began to clear, we see that many of the regular IR64 plants have died, and those that survived have severely stunted growth. In contrast, all of the IR64 plants containing Sub1 survived the flood. The whole plot is full of healthy rice plants, while the regular IR64 side has only sparse patches of growth. The final harvested rice piles show us a wonderful result. The yield of IR64 Sub1 rice is double that of plain IR64. Sub1 has saved the day. With that successful test, Sub1 varieties of rice exploded in popularity throughout Asia. Farmers across the region began adopting these submergent-tolerant rice strains, and as floods came through, their rice continued to thrive. In addition, they claimed the Sub1 rice tasted just as good as their traditional rice strains, further boosting their adoption by other farmers. Let's listen to the story of Mahaja, an actual farmer in East India who planted Sub1 rice. Currently, there are over 5 million farmers in Asia growing Sub1 varieties of rice, which has brought food security to over 70 million people across the continent.